Why do we even have water storage in our systems? Why not just pump water straight to the end user? Well, there are two reasons we don't do this. The first is that hydraulically, a pump would need to turn on and off as the pressure changes in the system. And this would require starting and stopping a machine that will wear out already too quickly. Secondly, we need tanks for emergency situations when, for example, there is no electricity in the system. If we have no water storage tank and the power goes out, even for a moment, then the system depressurizes and customers lose service. When it comes to water storage requirements, we build upon the conversation we had about water demand and think about what is a reasonable worst case scenario. When we start talking about the worst case scenario, we need to review the water demand pattern throughout the year. Remember this simple graph representing how water demand varies throughout the year? As you may recall, this line is the average usage or average day demand. Then somewhere in here is the maximum day demand. The relationship between the average day and maximum day is typically a simple factor that you apply. So when we talk about the worst case, we think about the moment that the power will go out and we also have a fire to fight on the hottest day of the year. This is typically the scenario when we plan for when we are sizing a tank in our systems. From this general concept, most water agencies provide water storage for these two conditions, the max day condition and the fire flow condition, and sum up the volume from both to get the water storage volume. These two conditions are referred to as duty and or operational storage and emergency for fire protection storage. For duty storage, we start with the maximum day demand. In other words, the water stored in the tank should be at least enough water to handle the volume of one day of the max day demand. As the max day demand is usually computed as volume per time, we just need to convert the units of time to one day to find this answer. For the emergency storage, the fire flow is assumed to be needed over a 4-hour time period. Given the type of construction in your system, you select a fire flow demand, typically given in units of volume per time again. But instead of converting the units of this flow to one day, we find the volume over 4 hours. Once you have these two values, then the storage requirement is the volume of one max day plus the volume of required emergency flow or fire protection. Let me pause for a moment just to say that each water agency has slightly different words for these values and may also have slightly different ways of computing these volumes. In the absence of any other guidelines, these are sufficient to get a conservative estimate for the water storage required. Let's assume that we just finished computing the water demand for a large community. The maximum day demand for this community is 5,000 gallons per minute. And based upon the structures that we are building in the neighborhood, we have a minimum fire flow of 1,500 gallons per minute. The volume of the maximum day demand after 24 hours of flowing is computed as 5,000 times 60 minutes per hour times 24 hours in a day. And this gets us 7.2 million gallons required just for the duty storage of one max day demand. Next, we do the calculation for the fire flow volume, which is the same as the max day demand, but the difference is that instead of 24 hours, you multiply by only 4 hours. And this yields a storage of 0.36 million gallons. So for this exercise, the storage is 7.2 million gallons plus 0.36 million gallons to get a total of 7.56 million gallons. From this point, you can take this information, then find the dimensions of a circular tank that meets the storage requirement. Let's start by deciding that the tank height should be about 30 feet. If that is the height of the tank, then we compute the required area as 7.56 million gallons divided by 30 times a conversion factor of 7.48 gallons per cubic foot. That gets us a value of 33,690 square feet. Now we solve the area equation for diameter, then plug in our numbers and get diameter equal to The square root of 33,690 times 4 divided by pi. That gets us 207.1 feet. We don't want the tank to be just barely big enough to hold the volume, so we round up to 208 feet. Therefore, our tank will have a diameter of 208 feet, a height of 30 feet, and a volume of 7.6 million gallons. As a final note, some potable water systems do not provide fire flow storage. Therefore, when computing the storage requirement, you can simply neglect that part of this computation. The reason why this is done is because the location is generally small, or the community does not have the funds to provide fire storage in their system. This is a major challenge in small communities. They often provide storage, but it's usually just enough to get by, or in other words, just to handle the operational storage requirements, and don't have enough in case of emergencies.